Thank you for joining me for another coaster review. This time we have Ruguru at Cedar Point. This is the new floorless roller coaster they have that is a replacement for their stand-up coaster Mantis. So they basically repainted it, gave it a new name, and stuck some floorless trains on it. Now this is a new style of coaster review that I'm doing, so I want to hear from you whether you like it or not. But anyways, let's get to the review. And right off the bat, one of the things that people often complain about is that this one can be jerky and it's a bit of a headbanger. So a lot of people aren't crazy about it and aren't impressed with Cedar Point's decision to turn this into a floorless coaster. Overall, most people are saying that it's better than Mantis. I, on the other hand, never got a chance to ride the Mantis. But I mean, it makes sense. Generally, people prefer sitting down than standing up. So I don't doubt that. But a lot of people are saying that this isn't that great of a floorless coaster. And the reason I'm saying that most people say that is because that is not what I think. I guess I'm one of those weird people that actually like Ruguru. I did not find it to be a headbanger. Now, I think it also comes down to the way that you're riding it. If you're riding Ruguru with your head back, then you have a bigger chance of banging your head up against the over-the-shoulder restraint. With a lot of these coasters with these B&M over-the-shoulder restraints, you have to keep your head forward, and so that makes it a lot better of an experience. So I got to ride this coaster twice when I was at Cedar Point, and both times I kept my head forward, and I did not find any headbanging at all. I found it to be smooth. Now, I don't know if this makes a difference, but also both times I rode it in the front row. I did not ride Ruguru in any other row. I think that the drop is great, the inversions are awesome. This thing has a vertical loop, a dive loop, which if you know me, I love dive loops. And then it also has this inclined vertical loop. And Ruguru is actually the only floorless coaster to have this inclined loop. And then it also has a corkscrew. And the corkscrew is probably my least favorite elements of the four. But it's not uncomfortable or anything, and I didn't even find it to be rattly. Like if you're at a coaster like Dominator, the corkscrews have a B&M rattle to it. I did not find a B&M rattle on this coaster, I found it to be smooth. So maybe I just rode it on a really good day, but I liked Ruguru. It had good forces, the elements were fun, and I think that converting it into a floorless coaster was a big success. Now I would have liked to have seen a little bit more done with the theming. They said that Cedar Point was going to run this thing with fog, but it ended up being more like a little bit of mist towards the bottom of the first drop, and it's actually kind of lame. So I wasn't really impressed with that. Really, the only theming that you're going to see is that you have a werewolf built into the logo. And when you're hanging out towards the bottom of the first drop, every once in a while you'll hear a wolf growl. I guess Cedar Fair is kind of doing that. They have that on Banshee and now they're doing this on Ruguru. Except they don't do it on Ruguru as well as they do it on Banshee. Now, in comparison to other floorless coasters, I didn't like this one as much as Bizarro at Six Flags Great Adventure. But I did like it better than Dominator at King's Dominion. And those are the only floorless coasters I've been on. I'm trying to get around to ride some others. But out of those, I place Ruguru right in the middle. And as usual with all of these videos, I always end with a final score. And this score is out of 10. And this coaster is earning an 8.5 out of 10. It is a very enjoyable ride. I liked it better than Gatekeeper. I think it's a very strong floorless coaster. I think it would have been kind of neat if they incorporated a few more inversions. But in terms of the layout that they have to work with, I don't really have anything to complain about. I found it to be a good ride, and I still don't quite get why people aren't fans of this coaster. Maybe it's because they weren't riding in the front row. Maybe it's because they didn't have their head forward and they had it back, and so they had some head banging. I don't know. I'd love to hear about it in the comments of why you aren't crazy about Ruguru. But I'd also love to hear about people who agree with me and think that Ruguru is as good as I'm talking about it. So if you make it up to Cedar Point, I definitely suggest riding it. And if you take in the tips that I've given you, then hopefully you'll have as good of a ride experience as I had. And with any luck, hopefully this coaster won't get a B&M rattle and it'll stay just as smooth as when I rode it this past August.